Remember, if you are new and you are enjoying the stream, make sure you are subscribed.
Oh, Jesus Christ. Oh my God, Precious Achua.
All right, let's get it. The Toronto Raptors win 5 in a row for the first time since August of 2020.
Winner,
they start the season 4-0 on the road for the first time in franchise history with a very clean, what was it in the end, 109-100 win against the Washington Wizards. The Wizards, this team ain't no joke. They are 5-3 now. They're 5-2 coming into tonight. Two straight losses for them. The Raptors started 1-3. They're now 6-3. Two straight wins without Scottie Barnes. Every game this season without Pascal Siakam. I'm excited to see this team fully healthy. But for now, we have this. The Raptors came alive in the second quarter to really take over this game. And I'll welcome you into my $9,000 studio for this one. So, the Toronto Raptors, pretty much great game all the way through. I thought that defense in the first half maybe lacked a little bit, rebounding especially, and maybe defense near the end of the third quarter was lacking. But other than that, an absolutely astonishing performance, especially on the offensive end. Fred VanVleet was absolutely unconscious tonight, shooting everything, and this man was not shooting to miss. 33 points, 13 for 22 from the field, 6 assists. Man, what a performance of Fred VanVleet. Every time we needed a big shot, I always question with the Raptors. You know, when you need the big shot, do we have the guy who's just going to be able to hit it? And well, today, that was Fred VanVleet. Absolutely sensational from Fred VanVleet. Let's take a look at the team stats for this one, first of all. So we go to the Raptors, who were great from three all night. 40% from three, 46% from the field. The half-court offense is really starting to get going. Dwindled a little bit at the end of the fourth quarter, but then they got it back, got themselves a clean victory. The rebound battle, we've been doing well from the rebounding front, even without our size. Turnovers are even. Basically, the free throw discrepancy kept the Wizards in this one. They had 30 free throws to our 20. A lot of suspect calls, I think, but hey, they're going to get into line. It doesn't matter. We got the win. Let's go to the individual box scores where let's start with the positives. VanVleet, like I said, amazing game. OG was great again. 9 for 20 from the field, 21 points. Gary Trent, solid performance. 6 for 6 in the field, 15 points. Had 10 in the first quarter, so fell off a little bit. Mihailuk has been sensational since coming in to fill for Scottie Barnes. Another 15-point game for him on a steal of a contract. 2 years, $3.6 million, so 1-1. But we have him this year for $1.8 million. The way he's chipping in is fantastic. Boucher, not great again, but better than previous games. Ken Burch, another absolutely sensational, stellar performance. The box score doesn't do it justice. Ken Burch has such an influence on the way the Raptors play, and it's been tremendous. One knock. Again, I'm not happy with Precious Achiuwa. 2 for 9 from the field. He was 1 for 9 from the field on Monday, and then he was 2 for 9 in the game on Saturday against Indiana. He was 4 for 9 against Orlando on the previous Friday. So he has been seriously struggling. And a lot of it is down to decision making. But today, a lot of it was down to just straight up missing his easy looks. So we got to get him sorted. Hopefully we can work on that and get him sorted, because he was really good. I thought he was really good the first few games of the season. But let's focus on the positives, because there are a lot of positives to look at with this. The Toronto Raptors have won 5 games in a row, which is incredible, which is absolutely incredible. My chat's telling me that we are now the 4 seed, which is also quite remarkable for this one. Wow. I gotta say, I was really concerned about this team after 4 games, but they've sorted a lot of their half-court offensive woes, and 5 in a row. We got Cleveland at home on Friday. Keep it going, man. No Scottie Barnes right now, but the next man up attitude is what is keeping this team afloat. I said on the main YouTube channel, Amateur Sports, I said, the next man up attitude, the reason the Raptors have this next man up attitude is that every time somebody checks in, nothing changes about the way we play. We play the exact same way no matter who's on the floor. So when Scottie Barnes gets injured, Steve Mihailuk comes in, we don't change anything. We play the exact same game that we were playing before, just with a different player on the court. The fact that he can spread the floor and be a menace from three, it also helps us out. It also adds a little bit to our offense. But We play the exact same way. And every player who steps on the court knows exactly what their role is on the court, and they can deliver. They know what they have to deliver. They know what they have to execute in order to make this team successful. And we have continuously shown that throughout this win streak. No joke, we haven't done this since August of 2020, 2 seasons ago. So it's great to get back in this. We're making history, 4 straight road wins to start the season, which is fantastic. Got to give a lot of credit to Nick Nurse for the way he's running the rotations, using the bench a little bit more when we were struggling. Brought in Malachi Flynn. I thought he was positive only in 3 minutes. Champagne checked in when it was necessary. He's going to the bench when he needs to. He's not scared to change up his rotations. He's being very flexible. And I'm very much digging the way we're playing. So the half-court offense continues to roll. A lot of it comes down to simply like Fred is hitting some crazy shots. OG hitting some crazy shots. They have definitely ascended their game from an offensive standpoint. And Gary Trent Jr., I'm also going to chip him into that. But the way Nick Nurse is kind of running this team has been so good to watch. The half-court offense, the reason it's getting better, I'm going to attribute it to the shot-making, but we're a lot calmer. Sometimes I felt in the early few games of the season, we were very, very quick, nonstop, always gunning it on offense. But now when we need to, we can slow it down. Precious Achiuwa didn't get the memo, but the rest of the guys are slowing it down a lot more on offense, creating better shots. Cam Birch in particular, sometimes, he's got a tough layup that he can hit, but there's also a better shot on the outside. And sometimes, Fred VanVleet has a chance to shoot a three, but there's an extra pass to a more open guy, and there's still 10 seconds on the shot clock. So let's work the clock a little bit more and see if we can get a better shot. Defense has been fantastic. The rebounding was great. We did a lot better of a job on Montrezl Harrell today than we did in the previous game against the Wizards. So all of these things combined are making this team successful. Lots of great individual performances, but the Raptors' strength is in their team. It's always a very deep team. It's always a very bench-oriented team when the Raptors are successful because every player can chip in because, as I said, every player knows their role, and we play the exact same way every time people check into the game. And all of this is happening right now without Pascal Siakam, who should be back in a couple of weeks. And the last two games have happened without Scottie Barnes. Hopefully, he's back for the Friday game. But even if he isn't, I still feel good about us beating the Cleveland Cavaliers. They're going through some health and safety protocol issues. I know that Markkanen is out. I know that Kevin Love is out. So let's just keep rolling, keep the momentum, keep doing exactly what we are doing. The Raptors are turning a lot of heads in the league. And after 9 games, 6-3, I thought like max we'd have after 10 games is like 5 wins. Already there with 1 more game to go. Remember, this team was 2-8 after 10 games last year. So the momentum we have with that 5-game win streak is just going to carry over. The vibes are immaculate. Let's just keep doing what we're doing. There's not a lot I need to say because every game, we're just reusing the same game plan and it's working. There's no reason to change it. The players that we need to hit shots are hitting their shots. I talked a lot about last season, how Fred VanVleet typically went missing in the fourth quarter because his half-court ability to create his own shot wasn't great. But he's hitting so many mid-range shots these days that it's like over 50% efficiency from mid-range. That he has more space to get to the rim. He's just simply hitting more shots and he's hitting more threes. So he's become the guy where I asked a question, when the Raptors are in a rut, they need a big bucket to end a run. Who's going to get that big bucket? Who's just going to will the ball into the basket? And right now, it's Fred VanVleet. And when we need those big buckets late, Fred VanVleet has been getting them. So I see no real weaknesses within this team right now. We don't have like that credible superstar to go after like the big dogs in the Eastern Conference. But this is a competitive team right now who is shocking a lot of people. Still very, very early in the season. But, I see no reason why we can't maintain the way we're playing. We got the Nets on Sunday. That's going to be a very difficult game. That's going to be the real true test of this team and see how good this team is or how good this team maybe is not. So all of that combined, so much fun to watch this team. So exciting. So much great things. Can't wait for the game on Friday. You can watch along every single Raptors game with me on the Twitch channel where I'm streaming right now. You're watching on the Clips channel, potentially twitch.tv/amateur sports. Link is in the description. Right now, I'm also doing a raffle for 2 Raptors tickets to the game against the Oklahoma City Thunder on December 8th. Adam will put the link in the description as well. Check that out. Minimum of $5 to enter the raffle. You can win some Toronto Raptors tickets. courtesy of MHR Sports. Yes, sir. Very excited for that. Let's get to 75 likes in this video and subscribe for a post-game show for every single game.